And today I'm going to discuss about an experiment from the Digital Signal Processing Lab, which is on frequency spectrum analysis of signal using discrete Fourier transform or DFT. The aim of this experiment is to compute the pulse rate for the given PPG data using the discrete Fourier transform and to compare the results of this pulse rate with the previously calculated pulse rate using autocorrelation function. Let's move towards the theory for discrete Fourier transform. In real world, almost all signals are continuous and analog in nature. So in order to analyze and process them, these signals are first sampled in time domain. Then we apply Fourier transform on this sampled signal to estimate the frequency spectrum of the signal to get the signal information and process it accordingly. This is referred to as the discrete time Fourier transform. And then we sample the Fourier transform to get the discrete Fourier transform. The equation for the endpoint DFT is given as follows. Xk, which is the kth DFT coefficient, is given as a summation of n equal to 0 to n minus 1. Xn, it is the input signal into e to the power minus j 2 pi by n kn, where e to the power minus j 2 pi by n kn is the Twiddle factor, and it can be broken down further in this form using the expansion for this term. So this form will be useful for writing the code in Arduino, as will be shown in this video later. Because in Arduino we cannot deal with complex numbers. So let's discuss the task for this experiment. And the task is to compute the pulse rate for the PPG signal from the frequency spectrum determined using the matrix representation of discrete Fourier transform. And the signal duration is given as 3 seconds and its sampling frequency is 25 Hz. So we can say that there are a total of 75 samples in the data. And let's go through the code. So initially the X variable contains the data and capital N represents the total number of samples, that is 75. And we will use these arrays in the below code. Fs is the sampling frequency, 25 Hz, and K and N are the same as mentioned before. So the pond rate is 9600, which is mentioned in the setup part. And in the loop part, we have the following procedure or algorithm to calculate the DFTs and then to measure the pulse rate from those DFT coefficients. So the code can be explained as follows. We have initialized these variables and then we apply moving average filter on the signal for removing the noise component from the PPG signal. So after moving average filter, we run through the whole loop to get the n DFT coefficients as mentioned in the formula, this formula. So we get xk, like, so we get 0 to n minus 1, we get n DFT coefficients. So this loop runs from k 0 to n minus 1. For each k we will get a DFT coefficient, and in the inner loop we have the this summation from n equal to 0 to capital N minus 1. So we can see n will be calculated here, and the real part is the signal moving average signal value into cos of that, and the imaginary part can be calculated as moving average signal value into minus 1 into sine of that. So minus 1 is because we have a negative here, so expansion gets a minus sign. So therefore, we can calculate the real part. The summation keeps on happening for n equal to 0, small n equal to 0 to capital N minus 1, and then we get the final values in x real k and x imaginary k, and then we get the coefficient capital X of k using the square root of function. So So thus we have our DFT coefficients for all n terms, and then we can calculate the pulse rate for the PPG signal as follows. We have the location, and we need to find the first peak. This procedure is same as the one used for measuring pulse rate using autocorrelation last week. So we find the maximum location point, and then we multiply the maximum location point with the sampling frequency and divide it by total number of samples to get the beats per second, and then to get the pulse rate, which is beats per minute, we multiply it by 60. So the smoothened pulse rate, which means after moving averaging, the pulse rate is we can display it on the monitor. So this is the data we obtained for the pulse rate. Here is the DFT coefficients. So these are the, it is an even symmetric, so these two peaks we get for the DFT coefficients. This till here is the DFT coefficient, that's it. And then we have the last week's data, which was for pulse rate estimation using the ACF. This was explained in the last video, and so we can compare the results. The pulse rate for different blocks, we got smoothened PPG pulse rate, raw PPG pulse rate, and error. So we calculated pulse rate for block size of 500 samples, and this is how we got the values. So with the DFT coefficients, we are getting a pulse rate of 60, and with ACF function, we are getting a pulse rate of 68. So they are quite near to each other, and they are well within the error range. So both provide considerably good results.